It was quite a discovery. A robber confessed to killing an Osceola Forks teenager some 7 years earlier, burying her near her home.
Undercover agents using search dogs and snowmobiles combed the area.
Police found the body of Kerry Lynn Nixon and brought it to the state police crime lab.
It was so unusual.
Where Dr. Lowell Levine worked on the autopsy.
We spent 6 hours just, you know, by hand separating the roots so that we wouldn't lose evidence. And we were able to identify her. We were able to show the cause of death, which was a gunshot wound. She had gone to a store. She had a receipt in her pocket. The change was in her pocket of her jacket.
Dr. Levine was able to positively identify Nixon and also connect her to her confessed killer, Robert Jones. A success, especially when you consider this case was before perhaps the most exciting advancement in the history of forensic science, DNA. To see how the New York State Police Crime Lab works, we set up our own crime scene.
The suspect left investigators some clues. A cigarette butt, some hairs, gum, and some lint off of his boots. He also left behind his footprints as he ran away.
We brought our evidence to the lab and asked the assistant director to tell us what they would do with it. The boot lint would go to the trace evidence section. The experts figure out the boot was mass-produced, but if the suspect has that same type of shoe, bingo.
We've had some phenomenal results with cigarette butts.
Which, along with the gum and hair, would go here to the bioscience lab to be tested for DNA. That doesn't automatically get police their guy unless they have that person's DNA in their data bank or have gotten a sample from the right suspect. Our evidence would be checked in here, where drugs, guns, and blood wait for processing.
Some of the television shows are misleading. The cases cannot be resolved that quickly, and evidence cannot be turned around so quickly.
We have cut the time from 45 days to just a few.
Bob Edwards teaches crime scene investigation. The classes are
hugely popular.
3 years ago, the class had 15 people. Next year, 60 students are signed up. Like we did, the students work with mock crime scenes.
You need to understand biology and chemistry. Physics.
Because at the crime lab, science is the star. Solving a crime, just a hopeful byproduct. When everything aligns, however, the two are the best of partners. Old-fashioned police work meets modern technology in a crime-fighting marriage that's constantly getting better.